Juz 10, part 2, inshallah, we were on Suratul Anfal, English, will continue. So we were on ayah number 75. And those who believe after the initial immigrant and immigrated and fought with you, they are you. Meaning those who come and join are you. Afterwards, they are struggling in the cause of Allah along with you, side by side with you. They are of you. But those of blood relationship are more entitled to inherit in the decree of Allah. Indeed, Allah is knowing of all things. What we see in these two verses that Islam to be served in two ways. How? One is either the person should become a muhajir or he should become ansar. Who is muhajir? Is the one who leaves something in order to serve the religion of Allah. Who is ansar? The ansar is the one who helped his Muslim brother or sister who has left something for the sake of Allah. You see, when you take a step forward, you need something to encourage you. Here is the encouragement to help. It comes from Allah. It comes from the deed that you have done. That satisfactions come from it, but we as human beings, we need the support of each other. We need to help each other. And for example, a person is coming forward to learn deen of Allah, and aren't there people required to help them learn the deen of Allah? Isn't that so? Think about it. There was problems once a time when we learned the Quran. Didn't we need that something to help us learn the Quran? Sit in front of us, like how we go to the teacher and how we learn it. So that's how even for the Ansar, not only just this thing, they have to be helped by physically, financially, you know, they were. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was, you know, he left Makkah and they left their homes and their relatives, their business, their properties, and they left and joined the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in Medina. And in Medina, how could they have lived with the Ansar? Didn't open up their houses to them. And here, the days happens, we hesitate, like, you know, even to sit with next to the people. But here, like, you know, how they help in Medina, this is a example for all of us. So, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بَعْدِي وَحَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا مَعَكُمْ فَأُولَئِكَ مِنْكُمْ. Those are among you, those are of you, we have to come together. We learned that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I am a Zaim. Who is Zaim? The one who is guarantee or the guarantor. Guarantee or the guarantor here. And I am the Zaim, the one who believes in me and accepts Islam and this Hijrah. And meaning, I guarantee this person will have something. What is that? He will have house on the outskirts of Jannah and the house in the middle of paradise. And I am Zaim for the one who believes in me and accepts Islam and strives in the cause of Allah, a house on the outskirts of Jannah and middle of the Jannah and the house in the highest chamber of the paradise. This is the reward. And Surah At-Tawbah. This is the declaration of disassociation from Allah and His Messenger to those with whom you had made a treaty among the polytheists. Bara'atum min Allahi wa Rasulihi illa allazina ahadtum min al mushrikeen. So Suratul Tawbah or Suratul Baqarah, this surah not big, like, you know, here Suratul Baqarah, Suratul Tawbah not begin with Bismillah. Why? Because from the beginning of the surah, the first ayah of the surah, what does it do? It dissolving the contract that existed between the Muslims and the Mushrik at the time when this ayah was revealed. When a contract, when a peace treaty is being dissolved, then Bismillah is not going to be said over there. When Bismillah said when a contract is being made. So at Sulh Hudaybiyah, when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam instruct Ali radiallahu anhu to write the terms of treaty, he said, write Bismillah Rahman Rahim. And Suhail Ibn Amr from the side of Mushrikeen said, we do not know Ar-Rahman, don't write this. So you should write Bismika Allahumma. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked Ali radiallahu anhu to change it, Bismika Allahumma. So the treaty was being made, therefore Bismillah was written. Here the treaties are being annulled and they are being cancelled. So when they are being cancelled, that means Bismillah will not be sent. It will not be written. And the simple reason is that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't recite. That's it. So that's the reason, like in Surat Tawba, we are not reciting Bismillah before that. So it is open declaration from Allah and His Messenger to those with whom made the treaty of peace with among the polytheists. So here the treaty, like, you know, Bara, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is declaring. So travel freely, O disbelievers, throughout the land during 4 months. But know that you cannot cause failure to Allah neither during this time nor afterwards. That Allah will disgrace and the disbelievers. Suratul Anfal was revealed after the battle. And the battle Badr and the Suratul Tawbah was revealed after the conquest of Makkah. So the scene has completely changed. The situation has completely changed now. After the conquest of Makkah, we learn that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he sent Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu for Hajj. 1 year later, he sent Abu Bakr for Hajj. At this time, this ayah was revealed. And Ali Raziyallahu Anhu was sent with this ayah to recite to the mushrikeen. And that now any treaty you had with the Messenger of Allah has been, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has been dissolved. And you have 4 months in which you decide if you want to live here in the peace, then you should be by accepting Islam. Okay, this is the condition. They have to accept Islam. If you do not wish to live here anymore, you choose not to accept Islam, then you have to leave. You have to leave and you have the time of 4 months. And it is an announcement from Allah and His Messenger to the people on the day of greater pilgrimage that Allah has disassociated from the disbelievers, His Messenger. So if you repent, that is best for you. But if you turn away, then know that you will not cause failure to Allah and give tidings to those disbelieve of painful punishment. Now we see that this ayah, Ali radiallahu anhu recited them at Hajj, when there was a huge gathering of people. Why? So that everybody would come to know that now all the treaties have been dissolved, which means that now if anyone wishes not to embrace Islam, living in Makkah, living in surrounding the area of Makkah, then they cannot stay here anymore. Why? Because for the past decade, what had happened, you know, the people refused to accept Islam. First of all, they rejected the truth despite recognizing it, despite knowing it. They call Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam truthful, yet they call him Shair and Kahin, you know. And secondly, they had shown extreme violence to the Muslim. They had killed them, they had tortured them, and they had abused them. And so any of them would be allowed to remain in Makkah, in the surrounding areas, then what would happen? Again, things would go back to how they were. After a long struggle, peace has been established now finally in the region, and this peace could not be disturbed by letting this mischief makers remain in the area. So they have to be evicted and they must leave their base. So an open choice was given. So over here, an invitation for Tawbah, okay, has also been given. If you wish to repent, you can repent. But if you do not want to, then you have to leave. This is the condition. So accepted are those with whom you have made a treaty among the polytheists, and then they have not deficient towards you in anything or supported anyone against you. So complete for them the treaty until their term has ended. Indeed, Allah loves the righteous who fear Allah. Inna Allah yuhibbul muttaqin. So over here we learn that for the people from the mushrikeen who has been honest with you, who have not bothered you, who have not cheated you or killed you, who have respect the terms, you have agreed to the treaties with them, they will continue the contract with them. They will continue. So we see over here that this was not a bias against mushrikeen, because many use this ayah to show, oh, look how the violent in Islam. No. look like, no, look how it doesn't tolerate other religion at all. No, this is not the intolerance to other religion. This is the intolerance to mischief, okay? Intolerance to trickery and, you know, treachery. And for this, you know, they were tolerating, but now finally the hukum has been given. For all these years, the people who have been proven to be treacherous, now they are not welcome here, not welcome anymore. But those who wish to remain on their religion, they wish to remain mushrikeen, but they have shown honesty, then treaties with them will continue until their time of expiry. For iza ansalaka, and when the sacred months have passed, okay, meaning after the 4 months, over the sacred months have passed, then if you see any of these enemies in the regions, Makkah and the surrounding area, then kill the polytheist wherever you find them, and capture them and besiege them and sit in the wait for them, that every place of ambush. But if they should repent, establish prayer and give zakah, let them go on their way. Again, there is condition here. Indeed, Allah is forgiving and merciful. This is very important ayah, and that this is very easily misunderstood, very commonly used for misunderstanding this ayah. This ayah was revealed in particular context for a certain group of people. This is not a blanket statement, like, you know, just a blank statement that any disbelievers where you find, just kill them. No, it's not so. In the whole context, the ayah, they were warned. They were given 4 months, okay? It after that, they found in the region still willing to persist in their mischief, in their corruption. Okay, you have to catch this criminal wherever you find them, because these people were criminal. These people had killed many Muslims. They had raised weapons. They had created havoc all these years. So if criminals, if serial killers is found somewhere in the city, what is had to be killed? They are spot. We see today that how is self-defense police officers are allowed to shoot and so on. But here they have given the time span, and then the, you know, they will take the action. So after that 4 months, if they don't agree, then they will be catched. But then also we see the whole ayah, if still they want to change, they have that time span. If they don't, then they have to leave the place. But in ahadam minal mushrikeen, and if any one of the polytheists seeks your protection, like, you know, they want your protection, so then what? Then grant him protection so that he may hear towards of Allah, that deliver him to his place of safety. That is because they are people who do not know. Here, meaning even if the enemy wants to learn Quran, hear the Quran, and for that purpose they want more time, then give them time. Why? Because Quran, what, like, they will learn and it will go in their heart. The ayah does not mean that tell a person on gunpoint, have a knife in your hand and, you know, okay, go. It's not so, okay? They misunderstood this ayah. And think about Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu. He is the one who came at Ahad and Uhud, and he is the one who had so many Muslims killed. What happened? He embraced Islam after several years. And when he embraced Islam, he was accepted as a Muslim. And then he brought so much benefit to Islam. Abu Sufyan also has embraced Islam after the conquest of Makkah. You know, Suhail bin Amr, he was brought at the Battle of Badr as a captive, war captive. He was imprisoned in the house of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And this man, when he was mushrik, he used to say a lot of harsh words against Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So Umar radiallahu anhu suggested, when he was brought in a captive, he said, Ya Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, cut his tongue off and allow me to cut his tongue off so that he cannot say anything against Islam. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, La, no, we do not do that. So what happened? Suhail, he gave his ransom. He went back to Makkah. And then at Sulh Hudaybiyah, he is the one who made the treaty with Muslims. And then eventually, he embraced Islam also. And then after the death of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in Makkah, we learn that there were some people who were planning to go back into their ways of disbelief, and they said Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has died. so now leave Islam and go back to our own ways. So Suhail bin Amr, he went up to them because he was also an elder in his people. So he said, do not be the last to believe and the first to leave Islam. So do not be of those people and the warn them. And he is the one who calmed them down, who gathered them together under the banner of Islam, who made them firm in Islam. So what do we see here? That don't hate a person simply because of his disbelief. Yes, disbelief is something that we should hate or dislike. But you know, later on, how they change. And here, so many people in the ignorance, they hate Islam, they hate Muslims, but they don't know the word of the Quran. When they hear the Quran, they accept Islam and they change their ways. So how can there be, but for the polytheists, a treaty in the sight of Allah and with His Messenger, except for those whom with you made treaty at Masjid al-Haram. So as long as they are upright towards you, be upright towards them. Indeed, Allah loves the righteous who fear Him. How can be there a treaty if they gain dominance over you? They do not observe concerning you and pact of kingship at or covenant or protection. They satisfy you with their mouth, but their hearts refuse. Just they are saying with their mouth. And most of them are disobedient. In ayah number 9, they have exchanged the signs of Allah for a small price and averted people from His way. Indeed, it was evil they were doing. That's the evil thing. They do not observe towards a believer any pact of kingship or covenant of protection. It is they who are transgressor. But if they repent, establish prayer and give zakah, then they are your brothers in religion. And here, and when we detail the verses for people who know, in this ayah we see the sign of Islam. What is the sign of a person's Islam? Is salat and zakat. And if they break their oaths after their treaty and defame your religion, then fight the leaders of the disbelief. For indeed, they are no oath sacred to them. Fight them, they might cease. In ayah number 13, would you not fight a people who broke their oaths and determined to expel the Messenger of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they had begun attack upon you the first time? Do you fear him? But Allah has more right that you should fear him if you are truly believers. Fight them, Allah will punish them by your hands and will disgrace them and give you victory over them and satisfy the breast of a believing people and remove the fury in the believer's heart, and Allah turns in forgiveness to whom He wills, and Allah is knowing and wise. Surah At-Tawbah, ayah number 16. Do you think that you will be left as you are while Allah has not yet made evident those among you which strive for His cause? Do not take other than Allah, His Messenger, and the believers as inmates, and Allah is acquainted with what you do. Allah is knowing. It is not for the polytheists to maintain the mosque of Allah while witnessing against themselves with disbelief. For those, their deeds have become worthless, and in the fire they will abide eternally. So here what we learn, you know, that imara of the masjid, serving the masjid, cleaning it or populating it, supporting or building, looking after it or attending it, this is benefit to whom? Only the person who has iman. Only the person, not the people who are mushrikeen. They used to do in the Makkah, but now the hukum, in fact, they were caretakers of the Makkah, this mushrikeen people. And the Muslim also had respect them. After all, the caretaker of Kaaba, Allah says, why do you have respect for them when these people associate partners with me? They do shirk. These people are not worthy of His honor serving the masjid. So looking after it, very noble deed, but it's very benefit to who? Only those who believe in Allah. The mosque of Allah are only to be maintained by those who believe in Allah and the last day, and establish prayer and give zakat, and do not fear except Allah, for it expected that those will be the rightly guided. And here, innama yamuru masjidallahi min amana billahi, those who believe in Allah, they have to. And here Prophet ﷺ said, There will be seven people who will be given the shade of Allah, Allah's throne on the day of judgment. And one of them is who? The person whose heart is attached to masjid. وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسْجِدِ. There is one more hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, the Allah will ask on the day of judgment, where are my neighbors? Where are my neighbors? And the angels will say, O Allah, who could be your neighbor? You are Zu Arsh, the possessor of throne. How? Who could be your neighbor? And Allah will say, Aina, where are Amir al-Masjid, those who used to populate the Masjid. Subhanallah. In another hadith, Allah will prepare for him who goes to Masjid morning and evening an honorable place in Jannah with good hospitality for every morning and evening he goes. Subhanallah. Ayah number 19. Have you made the providing of water for the pilgrimage and the maintenance of a masjid, Masjidul Haram, equal to the deeds one who believes in Allah and the last day, strives in the cause of Allah? They are not equal in sight of Allah, and Allah does not guide the wrongdoing people. We already discussed, iman is the key thing, even for the serving for the masjid. The one who have believed, immigrated, and striving in the cause of Allah with their wealth, and their lives are greater in rank in the sight of Allah, and it is those who are adherers of success. The Lord gives them good tidings of mercy from Him and approval, and of gardens for them therein enduring pleasure. They will be abide there forever. Indeed, Allah has with Him great reward. Inna Allah indahu ajran azima, great reward. And O you who believe, do not take your fathers or brothers as aliens if they have preferred disbelief over belief. Underline this ayah number 23. Even your fathers, your brothers, if they have preferred disbelief over belief, and whoever does among you, then it is those who are wrongdoers. And here, see, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if your father, your sons, your brothers, your wives, your relatives, wealth which you have obtained, commerce where you fear decline, and dwellings with which you are pleased are more beloved to you than Allah and His Messenger and jihad in cause, then wait until Allah executes His command. And Allah does not guide the divinely disobedient people. Disobedient people, Allah does not guide those people. So here we have to understand, if they are disobedient, Allah may guide the people. Only we should ask Allah for the guidance, and also we should seek that path. Allah has already given you victory in many regions, and even on the day of Hunain, when your great number pleased you, but it did not avail you at all, and the earth was confining for you with its vastness, then you turned back fleeing. So your richness will not bring you victory. Who will bring you victory? Allah will. Because sometimes we think that Allah, let me get very, very rich, then I will help the masjid. And then what happens when a person gets too rich? Then he is too busy looking after his money. Then Allah sent down His tranquility, peace, upon His messenger and upon the believers, and sent down soldiers, angels who did not see, and punished those who disbelieve. And that is the recompense of the disbelievers. So they were given the Sakina. Then Allah will accept repentance after that for whom He wills, and Allah is forgiving and merciful. O you who have believed, indeed polytheists are unclean. Means this doesn't mean they are untouchable, but rather they are spiritually unclean. So let them not approach at Masjidul Haram after this, their final year. Only clean people can come to the place. Okay, and if you fear, you know, Allah will enrich you from His bounty if He wills. And remember, you know, Hajjatul Wida, the year after this surah was revealed, then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed farewell pilgrimage. You know, there were 100,000 Muslims who performed the Hajj. The numbers multiplied, you know, the risk came, but you have to struggle first. Indeed, Allah is knowing and wise. Ayah number 29, fight those who do not believe in Allah or in the last day, who do not consider unlawful what Allah and His Messenger have made unlawful, who do not adopt the religion of truth from those who were given the scripture. fight until they give the jizya willingly while they are humbled. In ayah number 30, the Jews says Ezer is the son of Allah, and the Christian says Messiah is the son of Allah. That is their statement from their mouth. They imitate the saying of those who disbelieve before them. May Allah destroy them. How they are deluded. Hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none is more patient than Allah against the harmful saying. Meaning, you know, when somebody is saying harmful about Allah and doing shirk, that is what it means. They say they have given their scholars and mocks as lords besides Allah. They think that way. And also the Messiah, the son of Mary, they were not commanded except to worship Allah. There is no deity except Him. Means Allah exalted is above whatever they associate with Him. They want to extinguish the light of Allah with their mouth. Ayah number 32. But Allah refuses except to perfect His light, although the disbelievers dislike it. And it is who has sent His messenger with guidance and religion of truth to manifest over all religion, although they who associate others with Allah dislike it. O you who have believed, indeed many of the scholars and monks devour the wealth of people unjustly and avert them from the way of Allah. Those hoard gold and silver spent on not in the way of Allah give them tidings of painful punishment. The day when it will be heated in the fire of hell and seed them with their foreheads, their flanks and their backs, it will be said, this is what you hoarded for yourself to taste what you used to hoard. This is the punishment for not giving zakat. What is that? The wealth, that gold and silver will be heated in fire and they will be pressed with it. Okay. In hadith, we learn that wealth from which zakat has not given, it will come in form of a bald snake wrapped around a person's neck biting him. Why? What is that snake? It is the money from which zakat was not given. When this ayah were revealed, Sahaba, they asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then what is that we should really accumulate? Because gold and silver, we are scared that if we don't give, then we are in trouble. What is that we should really take? What wealth is best? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there's a hadith, it said, the best wealth is the lisanuz zikr. Okay, the remembrance of Allah. And Allah much a heart that is grateful and believing wife who will help him in the matter of Iman. So indeed the number of months with Allah is 12 lunar months. Okay, is the register of Allah from the day He created the heaven and earth. Of these are 4 sacred, that is correct religion, and do not wrong yourself during them. Meaning during the 4 sacred months, and fight against the disbelievers collectively as they fight against you collectively, and knows that Allah is with righteous who fear Him. In Nama, indeed, the postponing of restriction within sacred month is an increase in disbelief, because mushrikeen, what they would do, like, you know, if they wanted to fight, they would say, you know what, let's have move to the month of Haram. You know, they change according to their will. And by which those who have disbelieved further astray, they make it lawful 1 year and they make unlawful 1 year to correspond to the number made unlawful by Allah. They change the month. So it is talking about that. Lawful, what Allah has made lawful, made pleasing to them is the evil of their deeds, and Allah does not guide the disbelieving people. Surah At-Tawbah, Ayah 38. O you who believe, that is the matter with you. When you are told to go forth in the cause of Allah, you adhere heavily to the earth. Are you satisfied with the life of the world rather than the hereafter? But what is the enjoyment of worldly life compared to the hereafter, except a very little? So there is a hadith. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was said, explain to us the how khalil, how little this worldly life is, enjoyment is. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if one of you should dip his finger in the ocean, then he should see as to what has stuck to it. Meaning that much. And there is one more hadith that Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah has made this entire earth very khalil, very little. What is remain from it now is nothing but little, very little. And here, fama mataul hayati dunya, but little is the enjoyment of the life of this world compared to the hereafter. Illa tunfiru, and if you do not go forth, if he will punish you with painful punishment and will replace you with another people, and you will not harm with him at all, and Allah is over all things competent. You know, Allah is Ghani. Allah don't need that he can replace with other people. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we don't do any khair work, any good deed, anybody else will do it and they will get that reward. So we should be haris for achieving the good deed. If you do not aid the prophets, and yes, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is no longer there, but his legacy is still alive, his mission is still alive, his ummah is still there. Allah has already aided him when whose disbelief had driven him out of Makkah as one of two. Like, you know, when they were in the cave, Saur, he said to his companion, "Do not grieve, indeed Allah is with us. La tahzan inna Allaha ma'ana." If you remember this ayah, short ayah, but you know, la tahzan, do not grieve. Inna Allaha, indeed Allah. Ma'ana is with us. So whenever you are grieved, remind yourself Allah is with us. And because Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu became very worried as mushrikeen were literally at the mouth of the cave. And Allah sent down his tranquility upon him and supported him with angels. You did not see he made the word of those who disbelieve with the lowest, while the words of Allah, that is highest, and Allah is exalted, might and wise. Go forth, whether light or heavy, and strive with your wealth and your lives in the cause of Allah. Why? That is better for you if you only know. Had it been any easy gain and moderate trip, the hypocrites would have followed you, but distant to them was the journey. And they will swear by Allah, if we were able to, we would have gone forth with you, destroying themselves through false oath. Allah knows that indeed they are liars. And hear me, Allah pardon you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why did you give them permission to remain behind? You should not have, until it was evident to you who were truthful and you know who were the liars. This is ayah number 43. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered the people to prepare for the battle, hypocrites came to him seeking permission to stay behind, and they came with excuses. One person said, "Oh, I am not well. I have this, I have that." You know, some excuses, false excuses. And Allah's Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he kept allowing them, you know. Allah says, "Why did you allow them? You should not have allowed them, you know." So here, he was very innocent. He didn't think, you know, Allah always, you know, inform Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam through wahi, who are hypocrites and who are lying. And those who believe in Allah and the last day would not ask permission of you to be excused from striving with their wealth and their life. So they do not even take it as an option for themselves. And Allah is knowing of those who fear Allah. For those who are passionate about religion of Allah, they don't go on seeking permission. Can I be excused? You know, when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went for Tabuk, he appointed Ali radiallahu anhu in Medina to take care of his family, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam family was huge. So Ali radiallahu anhu was made to stay behind Medina. Now what happened? The Muslims are getting ready and they leave. When they left, Ali radiallahu anhu put his arms on, got on the mount and ran and joined Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are leaving me behind with the women, the children, the old, and the people who are known to be hypocrites. I am staying behind. I have to go with you. It doesn't make sense that I am staying behind. You are struggling in the way of Allah." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, "No, Ali, you go back. Why you are like Harun al-Islam, like, you know, how he was to Musa. Musa had to go. Remember, we learned about Musa al-Islam going to the mount and how he got the Torah, and you know how Harun al-Islam took care of the behind." So that's how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling to the Ali radiallahu anhu. So he has to take care of the Wallahu alimun bil muttaqin. And those who is that look for the excuse is, you know, Allah is with the people who are muttaqin. Only those who would ask permission of you do not believe in Allah and the last day, and whose hearts have doubted and they are in doubt and hesitation. If they had intended to go further, they would have prepared and preparation, but Allah disliked their being sent. So He kept them back, and they were told, remain behind with those who remain. In ayah number 47, had they gone forth with you, they would not have increased you except in confusion. If they go also, they will create confusion, and they would have been active among you seeking to cause fitna, more trouble. And among you are avid listeners to them. Sometimes if somebody is not coming, if they create more fitna, it is beneficial for us that they are not coming. And Allah is knowing of the wrongdoers. They had already desired dissension before and had upset matters for you until the truth came and the ordinance of Allah appeared while they were averse. And among them is who says, permit me to remain at home and do not put me to trial. You see, people came with different excuses, false excuses, but only mentioned in the Quran was that the man came, Ibn Qais, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I have heard Roman women are very beautiful, and I'm a man whose weakness is woman. So if you take me there, I might end up doing something wrong. This is absurd, women are beautiful everywhere. This was just he was just doing a pretense, he's showing like, I'm so pious, I have to stay behind, I don't do sin, I will stay behind, I don't want to commit any sin, so I can go to Quran teachers to, that's how he was just doing the riya and showing that excuses to remain behind. Unquestionable into trial they have fallen, and wa inna jahannamala, and they indeed they will be in Jahannam and encompass for the disbelievers. If good falls is distress them, but if disaster strikes you, they say, we took our matters in hand before and turn away while they are rejecting. Qul, say, never will we struck except by the what Allah has decreed for us. He is our protector, and upon Allah is the believers rely. You see, sometimes when a person goes in the way of Allah, he suffers. So you have to believe in Allah. And here in ayah number 52, say, do you await for us except one of two best things, while we await for you that Allah will afflict you with punishment from Himself or at your hands. So wait, indeed we along with you are waiting. Say, spent willingly or unwillingly, never it will be accepted from you. Indeed you have been a disobedient people. So here ayah number 54, and what prevents their expenditure from being accepted from them, but they have disbelieved in Allah and His Messenger, and they come not to pray except while they are in lazy, they are kusala that time, and they do not spend except while they are unwillingly, talking about hypocrites. So let not their wealth or children impress you. Allah only intends to punish them through them in worldly life, and their soul should depart at the death while they are disbelievers. And they swear by Allah, they are from among you, while they are not. They are people of afraid, who get afraid. If they could find a refuge or some caves or any place to enter hide, they would turn to in while they run heedlessly. And among them are some criticize you concerning the distribution, charities. If some they are given from them, they approve. But if they are not given from them, at once they become angry because they were not given. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, let the slave of dinar and dirham, let him perish as he pleased. These things are given to him. If not, then he is displeased. Let such person perish and relapse. And if he pierced with the thorn, let him not find anyone to take it out from him. Why? Because this is the height of selfishness. And if only they had been satisfied with Allah and His Messenger, gave them said, Hasbunallah, is sufficient is Allah. Allah will give us His bounty and messenger. Indeed, we desires towards Allah, it would have been better for them. And zakat, expenditures are only for the poor. This ayah number 60 is very important. And for the needy, for those employed to collect zakat and for bringing heart together, for Islam, for freeing captives, all the details has been given here. And for those who debt and for in the cause of Allah and for the standard traveler and for the obligation imposed by the Allah and Allah is knowing and wise. In particularly, this ayah teaches who are the recipients of the zakat to whom we can give. You can study detail. In ayah number 61, among them are those who abuse Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say he is an ear. Say it's an ear of goodness for you. Say it's an ear of goodness for you, the believers in Allah and the believers in the mercy of those who believe among you, and those who abuse the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for them is a painful time punishment. They swear by Allah for you Muslims to satisfy you, but Allah and His messenger are more worthy for them to satisfy. They should be believers. Do they know that whoever oppose Allah and His messenger, for him is the fire of hell, and they will be there forever. The hypocrites are apprehensive lest a surah has revealed about them, informing them of what is in their hearts. Say, mock as you wish. Indeed, Allah will expose that which you fear. And if you ask them, they will surely say, we were only conversing and playing. Say, it's Allah and His verses and His messenger that you were mocking. Make no excuses. You have disbelieved after you believe. We pardon one faction of you. We will punish another faction. They were criminal. The hypocrites, men and hypocrite men are of one another. They enjoyed with wrong and what is forbidden and close their hands. They have forgotten Allah, so He has forgotten accordingly. Indeed, hypocrite these who are defiantly disobedient. Allah has promised the hypocrites, men and women, disbelievers, the fire of hell, and they will be there. And you disbelievers are like those before you. They were stronger than you in power and abundant in wealth. They enjoy their portion of worldly enjoyment, and you have enjoyed your portion. And if you have engaged in vanities like this, they engage too, and hereafter, and they are who are the losers. Has there not reached from the news of those before them, the people of Nuh and the tribes of Ad and Samud and the people of Ibrahim and Madian overturned, they were overturned, their messengers came to them with clear proofs, and Allah would never wrong them, but they were wronging themselves. The believing men and believing women are aliens to one another. They enjoy what is right and forbidden what is wrong, and they establish prayer, give zakat, and also believe in Allah and the messenger. Allah will put mercy, and indeed Allah is exalted and wise. And Allah has promised the believing men and women garden beneath which river flow. There will be abiding therein forever and ever. There is a hadith learned that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in paradise there will be for a believers a tent, meaning house, and a room of a single hollowed pearl, meaning it would be a pearl. So you can imagine the smoothness and the shine, the breadth of which you would be 60 miles. O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fight against the disbelievers and the hypocrites, and refuge for them is hellfire. They swear by Allah they did not say anything against Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is talking about the hypocrites. And in ayah number 75, among them are those who made a covenant with Allah saying He should given us from His bounty, we will surely spend in charity. But when He gave them from His bounty, they were stingy, they did not give. So He penalized them with the hypocrites in their heart until the day we will meet Him. And then those who criticize the contribution among the disbelievers concerning their charities and criticize nothing spent except ridicule for them. For ask forgiveness for them, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do not ask forgiveness for them. If you should ask forgiveness for them 70 times, never will Allah forgive them. This is because they disbelieved in Allah and His messenger. So that is the thing, they were disobedient. Those who remain behind rejoice in their staying at home after the departure of the messenger of Allah, and dislike to their wealth and their lives in the cause of. So do not go forth in the jihad. Yahya bin Jada said, the fire that you kindle is a 70 portion of the fire in the hell. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, last night I saw a dream, two men coming to me. One of them said, if a person who kindled the fire is Malik, meaning it has been kindled and left. So let them laugh a little and weep a more. That's recompense what they used to earn. If Allah should return to a faction of them after the expedition, they ask you permission to go to the battle. You will not go with me ever. You will not go with me ever. You will never fight with me and with enemy. Indeed, you were satisfied with sitting at home. So there is a hadith. Aisha radiallahu anhu said that Messenger of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, people will continue keep themselves away the front roll until Allah will keep them away. Allah will keep them away. This is in Abu Dawood. And do not pray at the funeral. Pray over them who has died ever or stand his grave. Indeed, they disbelieve in Allah. And let not their wealth and their children impress you. Allah intends to punish them. And when Surah was revealed enjoined to believe in Allah and to fight with his soul, they permission stay back and said, let us to be with them as to sit back. They were satisfied to be with those who sit back. And here in the end, we see in the ayah number 89, Allah has prepared for them garden beneath it because they were believers where they will abide eternally. That is a great attainment. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Jazakallahu khairan katheera.